Hey guys, welcome to the review. Fuck.
Prey is a game that fully encapsulates the office job experience.
At Blizzard.
In this, Venom Let There Be Garbage Recycling, we play as Morbius Freeman, a man optional, with heavy memory loss and autism, whose only instinct is to induce as much blunt force trauma as humanly possible upon all living things. We follow him as he bulldozes through an entire alien race and occasionally other humans, within the confinements of Detroit in space. Have you ever wanted to contemplate the illusion of life as we know it in a beautiful, philosophical, horror survival game like a normal person, then that's fine. But if you're a psychopath like me and are more interested in destroying the universal gene pool with a wrench, then you've come to the right place. Along the way, we study the creatures that escaped God's recycling bin and subsequently send them back to him. So, come with me on an adventure as we explore the Cleveland Zoo exhibit in a video game that people slept on harder than a Disney princess. In this complete, extensive, factually correct, politically incorrect, and psychotic analysis of Prey. We start the game by selecting our Twitter pronoun, and we wake up in our apartment by a call from our brother, Amazon Alexa. We meet him at a testing facility where he teaches us the basics of, well, being a good person, you know, and putting others' needs in front of ours, and most importantly, hide from the IRS.
Morgan, we can see you there.
But the tests are cut short by some chimps that escape their enclosure. Too bad there's no gun this time. What the fuck? Ugh, what now? Hey, my name's January. I'm an advanced toaster you made to remember things. Cool. Why would I make you? Can't remember. Listen, you've been experiencing the same day for 3 years because of Alexa, and now some aliens have broken containment.
He's a straight minute.
You gotta fix that or they'll kill everybody.
I mean, that doesn't seem too bad. I guess I could survive. If you don't, you'll miss Keanu Reeves getting elected as president.
Real shit! So after we wake the fuck up, we're able to collect our wrench and use it to escape the metaverse.
Hi sisters!
Welcome one and all to Talos 1, a luxurious space station complete with chairs, crabs pretending to be chairs, and of course the... I don't know if you've noticed, but your health bar is going down, and it's time for me to give you the 13 reasons why. These are the Typhon. They exist with the only purpose to cancel your membership to life and give you free acupuncture. Made out of black tar, they can assume many forms and have different powers. The mimics shapeshift and hide just to jump you when you least expect it, just like me at your house tomorrow. The Phantoms have multiple variations. We have the basic bitch, Red Bull Electrolytes, Kagiban Shin no Jutsu, and 2020 Australia. Of course, as you progress the game, harder enemies will appear and your arsenal will also increase, making sure that the game is challenging and painful, but mostly painful.
We'll get back to that shit. Right now, we have to learn how to play the game, cause our character has no fucking clue. This is, as I mentioned before, our brain resembles Swiss cheese and the game's objective is more complicated than a woman.
We therefore learn how to craft stuff and recycle. This is most of the game.
We also have a video that reminds ourselves what we have to do, that's sabotaged by Alexa's plus 18 filter. So we reboot the Wi-Fi router by going out for a spacewalk whilst having to shoot aliens. That's supposed to be a cool sentence, but the game's microgravity sections are limited to sensitive controls that make it seem like you're looking into the 8th dimension.
I'm currently spinning uncontrollably.
Hey
Hey guys, welcome to the game. That's right, 2 hours in and we've just finished the intro. And now we're off the leash and able to go off on the Typhon like a dog at a child. By now you should have expanded your arsenal to its fullest. In addition to the wrench and the cum gun, we have the pistol for crowd control, a shotgun for maximum death, and a Q-beam, a portable Chernobyl reactor. On another level, these weapons are complemented by the various throwables. The EMP stops electric types from doing anything and is pleasing to the eye. The null wave transmitter does a thing. The recycler charge is a throwable slash kill command that drags everything into, I guess, Brazil? And the Typhon lure, which is a useless epileptic seizure. Seriously, why is this a thing? On another other level, we have the neuromods, injections of pure lean straight into your frontal lobe through your fucking eyeballs. You're able, through the skill tree, to gain the abilities such as carrying large objects, also known as the American Man, or just throwing things harder. My favorite is maxing out on stamina and mobility, turning me into a hostile, meth-driven cat at 3 a.m. On another other level, we have the psychoscope, which allows you to scan the Typhon.
Yo, who the fuck?
And gain their powers from the neuromods. We also have some new Typhons. You thought I was done? The Weaver flies, creates exploding testicles, and moves the mouse for you every time you attack it. The telepaths brainwash humans and send them after you to attack, much like an online influencer.
You should kill yourself now!
The technopath is a dick. It flies, electrocutes you, sends robotic minion cucks after you, and steals your turrets.
Oh man, I can't have shit in this house.
But most devastating of all is that it disables your propulsion system. God forbid you have to fight one in anti-gravity, because if it shocks you, and it fucking will, you lose the ability to move and you're stuck waiting for your turn that's never coming. Then there's the military operators, but we don't talk about them. And lastly, we have the nightmare, named after what he gives me. He exists to replace bosses and fragment my bones. Despite this, the combat system in this game is dope. You know, when my computer decides to function properly. All you have to do is kill the black spaghetti. But you also have to single-handedly learn each one's weakness so you're able to do this faster. Every neuromod you install has to be of use to you, or else you're a fucking cuck. You have to keep an eye out on your enemy, your health, your armor, your piss counter, Typhon abilities, ammo, throwables, all at the same time, all the time. To get the full experience, I suggest you play on hard mode, forcing you to economize your utility and get the drop on the enemy instead of removing all strategy from the game with the shotgun. Everything is weak to the shotgun. Prey relies highly on the combat to carry the game, but the question is, does it make up for anything that might make the game repetitive? The answer is unfortunate. Playing Prey is like walking backwards on a treadmill. You have to backtrack a lot, but it's not a game that's made for that. Hey, you remember your office where you fought your first Phantom? Well, you're gonna have to backtrack here like 7 times. And yes, every time you come here, have 2 telepaths and a Weaver along with absolutely no visibility. Fuck you. So is that it? Prey is a bad game? The answer is no. Prey likes its players to be creative both in combat and progressing the game. So go do your own thing and treat this game like Elden Ring and make your build based on your playstyle. However, much like Elden Ring, if you choose wrong, you will not have fun. By the time you get back to a previous location, your arena is automatically bigger. This is because the build you chose allows you to reach a new location you couldn't before, giving you more possibilities. Talos 1 is a public playground, Morgan an abnormally sized pit bull. There's no right way of playing this game. It is your way of playing this game, King. Now that's all said and done, it's time to get into the sweet, juicy lore. It's not required to know the full backstory to enjoy the game, but past events have to be exposed and dealt with accordingly. I know what you did, Jonathan. The year is 1958 and the Russians are in space preparing for the Cambodian genocide. However, the Typhon within their satellite break out and send them back to the Fortnite lobby. Russia's like, yo, we want some hip. Hey America, you want in on this? Yeah, we can have fun in our new convertibles now. A very alive Kennedy sets an operation to contain the Typhon Kakazonglikis and builds the research center around the satellite. The Typhon break out and then the station is abandoned. Some rich people take over with the power of capitalism and a smidge of violence.
Damn, boy, he's thick.
Upon turning it into an innovation center, they instantly ask themselves if they want to be immortal and have awesome cool powers that will cause humanity's downfall. They do that and start studying the Typhon with Alex and Morgan at the head of operations, with each their stand. They manage to implement the alien goo powers into them at the cost of everyone liking them. But Alex's timbers are positively shivered by this and turns Morgan's brain into mush through a simulation. The Typhon once again inevitably break out. Morgan, now at the same brain capacity as my fucking shoes, is called upon to kill them all.
I'm gonna come find you.
Going through lockdowns, containment breaches, and reactor sabotages, our end goal is to either give Talos 1 the Al-Qaeda treatment or go with your Oni-chan's plan, which is give the Coral, being the psychic link between the Typhizers, super brain death. But in the end, none of that matters, because the entire story was in reality a simulation by, you guessed it, Jeff Bezos. In the game, you're playing as a Typhon, seeing Morbius? In the game, you're playing as a Typhon, seeing Morgan's memories, in hopes of saving humanity. And yep, that's pretty much the game, and everything you need to know about it. But don't take my review for it. This game is a goddamn experience, and it would be a crime for you to watch this video and not play it. Am I being sponsored by Arkane Studios? No. Am I biased? Fucking absolutely.
Keep having this dream.